meet HEPA specifications. If I do not use this bag, it will not meet HEPA specifications. So it's the combination of the two, okay? This is the plate which you put in the ovens, or which I got down, okay? That keeps the bag from getting on the motor, which used to be an issue, okay? Now it's not an issue. These vents here with this plate always directs airflow through here, okay? Which brings the airflow all the way over the back. Okay. Now, the issue that you have with a round back, okay, the motor's on the bottom, my motor's on the bottom. But look inside the Pro-Team or any of the round ones, they're smooth. Expands up against the inside of the unit. The vacuum's coming from here, the intake's up top. As this fills up with dirt,
just fix the airflow.
Vacuum goes down because they're having to suck through this much dirt. Okay, with ours, because we direct the airflow up to the top of the bag, when my bag is 90% full, I'm still performing like I was brand new.
Okay.
Our exhaust is here on the side. Okay, it's also diffused, which means that it's not just blowing straight out the side. There's a diffuser there that deflects all the. So we're not blowing on the operator. This brace here, one of the issues with backpacks is they get hot. They get hot on the operator. Okay, we have this brace separating our motor from the operator. Then we have this separating this brace from the operator, and it allows airflow. Okay, so I'm not as hot on the operator's back. Especially the ladies, if they set my vacuum down like that and use it, there's no issues. You set the Pro-Team like that, or any of the round ones with the filter on the bottom, you can't exhaust when you set it down on the ground. Therefore, oops, trouble, we're overheating the motor. Pads, make a comparison. Much thicker. Okay, so here again, more comfort. Now, it's not an issue, but if they don't put the vacuum on the right way, there's where we get into an issue. Because this belt is the whole key to wearing it. It has to be tight, because that's supporting the weight on the back. Not the straps. I can take the straps off. Okay? So that's where the weight is. That's more ergonomic than something that's strapping onto your shoulders. In fact, what I can do, I can only have to wear one strap. Just this strap, give it a little more support. Now, when I'm vacuuming, the strap's not cutting into me. I'm doing above floor cleaning, it's not cutting into me. So here again, more comfort. I also, my hose comes under the arm, right? The hose that comes out of the top keeps hitting you in the head. Especially here again for ladies. I've talked to so many ladies that, I hate that, I hate it. So our hose comes under the arm. Either way, it does pivot. So if you're right-handed or left-handed, okay. But this comfort level is really, really huge. Okay. My switch is warranty for 3 years. Okay. We don't have issues with the switches. With this, I've got a crevice tool built in. Yeah. So if I'm doing up here, I don't need to go get a crevice tool. I've already got a crevice tool built in. Now, with this, I've got this light. Why the bend in the wand? You can actually take it off, turn it around to make an adjustment. It lowers the height of the wand. Also, when you're doing your above floor cleaning, I've got the right angle. now with this one. So I can do that. I'm doing here. I've got my right angle to do all my above floor cleaning. We also have aluminum, and this is stainless steel. It actually comes painted aluminum. So it's much, much lighter. So when they're doing above floor cleaning, you can add sections on to get as long as you want. And painted aluminum, I can stand here on the bottom and I can vacuum all the way up to the top. And you can get these in 4 foot sections. This is the tool that we were talking about, the Sidewinder tool. Okay. And for it, actually here, I'm vacuuming this way. Okay. When you order the kit, it actually comes with this extra wand. So now, and I turn it sideways so I can get to, that's how much of an area I can cover. That, so if I need something big like that, I just turn it. If I get my edge cleaner, I've got my edge cleaner. See, it picked it up, that little piece went down under. Mm-hmm. It was below it.
I mean, that's where you're getting. And it's narrow, so it gets it out to the end, too.
Narrow, that just picked up that piece of bag. To me, it's a non-issue.
Here again, another reason not to have the screw.
All right.
I don't want to pick that up. It's easier for me to pick up big debris, right? I just pop that off. I pick up my big debris. I keep going. So if I had the screw on, right, I got to unscrew it before I can do that. So I can do the job quicker.
If I go from here, here, over to here, I mean that's 7 to 8 inches of coverage. Okay. So for high productivity tools, these are high productivity tools. Okay. Now we have other tools. We have all the tools. You know, the little scallop tool, their quote unquote high productivity tool, is like this. Twisting your back, keeping your position here the same, because of the articulation, that other tool will come off the floor. And you don't get the suction. It turns like this. So instead of cleaning 18 inches, you're only cleaning 1 inch. So that's where our advantage is with this tool. So it is a high productivity tool. In performance, because our bag fills up, because we're always, you know, because of the fins inside the tank, we're always directing airflow up to the intake where it is, so we fill up our bag. We do not lose performance as the bag fills up. We've got better filtration, because we're true HEPA right out of the box. We're not hazardous, you can't pick up asbestos or anything like that. We're quieter, so our decibel levels are lower. We're not exhausting onto your rear end, so we're more comfortable, we're cooler there. Okay. We're not having any issues with when they set it down. Our machine won't bounce and won't hurt the motor. We've got the variable wand to be able to allow you to do more with comfortable arm pads here. So all the vacuuming I did, I never had a strap cutting into my arm. Because all the weight is supported right here.
And I wouldn't recommend doing that, but I would just say if he's on a job and he can't.
Because that, the dirt's not going to adhere to it.
So if he doesn't have a vacuum bag with him, he doesn't have to say, oh, well, I can't vacuum because I don't have a bag. He can go ahead and complete his job without a paper bag.
I would think that because it's not paper, that it would just blow the dust and everything out of straight out of the top. You know that?
No, it won't.
Because it's like a vinyl.
You're talking about this?
Yeah.
Now, the only reason it's like this on the inside is so the dust and the dirt won't adhere to it. But no, it won't blow it back out the top.
Okay.
I've never had that happen.
Nope.
So it can be used bagless.
And then the reason it's slick inside is that we want it here to the bag.